Hey guys, welcome back to the Dress My Craft YouTube channel. Design team member Kanika joined this side. And in this video, we shall be making shaker cards. But before moving forward, make sure you hit the subscribe button and as well turn the bell notification on so you never miss an update from us. So let's get started. So these are the shaker elements which we'll be using today. So the first one are these kiwi slices. Let me show how these look. Aren't these so cute? So that's the first one which we will be using. The second one here which I have with me are these watermelon slices, and these are how they look. Link to where all these craft supplies is mentioned in the description box, so you can check that out. The third one are these orange slices. Moving on to the fourth one, here I have the strawberry slices. And look how cute these look. I am just drooling over these. Trust me, these are amazing. So the next one which I have are these cupcake with cherry. And you can create a lot of shaker elements with just one pack of these. The next one here are these sweet candies. So this is basically a mixture of different candies. So let me show these up like this, so you can see. And the candy size is little bigger than the previous slices, which you can see here. Now moving on to the next one, here I have the dessert mix, and these are again the tiny ones. So now let's get started with the card tutorial. So here I have created a stenciled background, and I have used the fishnet design stencil from Dress My Craft, and using my distress oxide vintage photo I have covered the background. For creating shaker, here I am using the window and pocket die, and with the biggest size of this I have done die cutting on 10 window pieces, and now I am simply chopping off the top part to create a square shaker element. Similarly, I have stacked them up, so these are a stack of 10 pieces. So no need to use the 3D foam tip. We can simply stack up the die cuts and create a window. So this time I am creating a transparent window, and for the top piece here I have used the acetate sheet and as well covered the top layer with the vintage photo. Now using my liquid adhesive, I am going to simply place the top layer on the rest of the die cut pieces so that we can stack them up and as well the shakers can move easily. So I'll just let it dry, and meanwhile I'll just add on the shaker elements. So here I'm just adding up the adhesive on the back side of the window as well and keeping it aside, and after this I'll be adding the shakers. So here firstly I'm using the dessert mix and I'm adding little bit of that. Then next, here I'm using the cupcake with cherry. And now I am adding the third mix. So for that, here you can see I can easily select what all designs I want to put in to complete my shaker element. And once I am adding all these elements, I am going to flatten up the shaker element so that they can easily move around and I can place over the transparent window like this. And that's how you can easily create your shaker element, and you can see all the elements are moving freely. And here to complete up my card, here I have done some fussy cutting using the Sweet Treats motif sheet. So these elements mixed perfectly with the shakers I used. So I had done some fussy cutting. This is how the sheet looks like, and I have as well fussy cut one of the sentiment. And now I'll be placing these all the elements on my card. So now I'm just arranging up the things so that I know that which element goes where, so that it will be easy to add on later. So now using liquid adhesive, I'm simply adding it down, and here you can see I'm using the fine and sharp tip tweezers from Dress My Craft, which are easing my work. Actually, I can hold up my tiniest and the miniest of my element with them and simply add the adhesive and place them down at the accurate position.
And you can see this is how it looks. Now it's time to add up the sentiment. So using the element sheet again, I have fussy cut one of the element and added black cardstock on the back side and as well 3D foam tape to give it a little bit of dimension. Now to add little more dimension to my project, on the lower side I am using the scalloped border punch and I am simply die cutting it like this, and I'll complete the border of the punch and it will give a very nice dimension like this, and that's how my card looks like. You can as well create fridge magnets using these beautiful shakers, and here you can see I have created a chopping board fridge magnet. And you can see I have used these slices to embellish the project. So now let's move on to the next card, and here we are going to create a Get Well Soon card, for which I have already done the background stamping using the script stamp. And like there, I have created a transparent window using the die cuts itself, and this time I'll be creating a different style of shaker. So for that, here I have taken a circle die cut piece and as well created the rings, and this time I added 3D foam tape on the back side. Now to add the slices, here I'm going to put up all these slices. Like here I'm using this fruit salad mix slice as well. Once you're done, you need to make sure you flatten up the space so that your shaker elements can move up nicely. So that's what I'm going to do here, and then later I'm going to simply add the top layer to cover up my shaker element, and then after doing it, my card shaker is done. Now on the top and the bottom side, here I have done some border punching using the scalloped border punch, and now I'm going to place over my shaker element like this. Using the liquid adhesive, I'm going to add it up, and then later to complete this shaker card, I'm going to add up a sentiment. So here I have stamped the image which says Get Well Soon, and on the borders I have done some punch cut out using the banner punch from Dress My Craft, and I have added 3D foam tape on the back side as well to give it a dimension, and now here I'm going to place it over like this to complete my card. And this is how easily you can create your shaker cards using the Dress My Craft shaker mixes, and try your hands on these amazing and beautiful shaker elements from Dress My Craft. Thanks for watching this video. I hope to see you soon again.